Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel, and today we are going to talk about SOC merchant recurrent problem. In this problem we have given an array of integers representing the color of each socks, and we have to determine how many pairs of socks with matching colors there are. We will first look at the input format. The first line contains an integer n, the number of socks represented in the array. The second line contains n space separated integer describing the color array of the socks in the pile. Let's try to look at the example first. This line represents the number of elements present in the array, which is 9 over here, and these are the 9 elements. Guys, here each number represents one color of the socks pair, and our task is to find out how many socks pairs are available. So here, if you can see, first element is 10 and we have one more 10 here, so this is one pair. 20 and 20, this is the second pair, and we have 10, 10, one more pair, so totally we have 1 plus 1 plus 1 equals to 3 pairs. This is the answer. So our task is to, we have given an array of n elements and we have to find out how many socks pairs are present. So let's try to understand the algorithm behind this. Here I am taking the same example, guys, which we have seen in a sample. So first, here we will take one set which is empty set and a variable or counter which will maintain the pair count. See, initially it will be 0, so you can see this is a count, and we will process the element one by one in a set. So whenever we found anything in the set, we will, it means we got the pair, and we will remove that pair, that element from the set, and increment the count. Let's see how we are going to do it. First we'll process the 10, so counter still will be 0, so we'll process the next element 20. So 20 is not present in this set, so we'll add the 20 here, counter still will be 0. We'll process the next element, which is again 20. So if you can see, guys, 20 is already present, it means we found the matching pair. So we'll just remove this element from the set and increment the counter, because we got one pair of socks. Now we'll process the next element, which is 10. As we can see, 10 is already there, so it means we got one more pair of socks. So we'll remove this element from the set and increment the counter to 2. Now we'll process the next element, which is again 10. So because it was empty, there was nothing, so you'll just add into the set, and still the counter will be 2. Now we'll process the next element 30, and we'll check whether 30 present in this set or not. Because 30 is not there, so we'll just add that element into the set, and the counter still will remain same. We'll process the next element, which is 50, and we will add into the set, because there is no 50 over here. Now we'll process again the 10, and we can see 10 is already there, so we'll remove the 10 from the set, because we got another pair of 10. So only 30 and 50 will be here, and we'll increment the counter by 1, because we got one pair of 10. Now we will process the next element, which is 20. So here you can see we will add 20 over here because 20 is not present here, and the counter will remain the same. So once we have done with the processing, we come to know set will be containing these three elements and the counter will be 3, which will tell this is the final result or this many number of pairs are present in the array. So this is the logic, guys, and now we'll see the solution. So this is the method, guys. In the method we have n, which represent the number of element present in the array, and input array. So we have taken a hash set over here, and this is the counter which will calculate the stock pairs count, and we are going through a loop, and we are looping from 0 to n minus 1, and we are taking each element from the array and checking whether the set contains that element or not. If set contains that element, we are removing that element from the set and incrementing the counter as we did in our algorithm. And if set does not contain that element, we are adding that element into the set. So once we have done with the loop, the counter or the count variable will hold the exact matching pair of socks, and we will return that. Let's try to run this code on HackerRank platform. So in this, I'm just copy pasting that code here and try to run. So guys, you can see sample test case got passed. Now I'll try to submit my code. Congratulations, guys, it is accepted by HackerRank platform. So I hope you got the idea how we are going to solve this question. Guys, I have committed the code on GitHub and link is mentioned in the description box, so you can download that code from there. If you think this video helped you to gain some knowledge, then please subscribe to my channel, guys. Thanks for watching.